Welcome everyone tonight to your first ever TM Geek inaugural championship tournament matchup. We do have an awesome matchup on our hands tonight. The 13 seed versus the 20 seed. We're going to see which one of these guys can get their first win and move on in the tournament towards the championship. Can't do this by myself. I'm happy I have somebody with me on the desk. It is Aaron. How are you doing, man?
I'm excited to be here, man. Like I said in our preview special, this tournament excites me. I like the idea of seeing which players can build momentum as we get towards our first champion. And I said yesterday, this is one of the matches in this first round that excites me the most. I think both of these guys have played, shown they can play well in other leagues and other divisions and other areas. It's just unfortunate they both ended with a loss here in this league first, meaning they're in round one. But yeah, it's exciting to see these two go at it, and it'll be an exciting first match for sure, I hope.
Absolutely. And, you know, anytime there's a tournament, there's always upsets, which are fun. So anytime that there's potential for an upset, whether it's in this match or maybe one of these guys moving on to the next round to face one of the winners that got a bye, which we will talk about. But yeah, anytime the word upset is thrown around, stuff gets all exciting. Anything can happen in a geek match. Everybody knows that. So let's go ahead and waste no more time. We'll bring in our first competitor. He is 20th ranked. He is the head of Nerd Entertainment Network and Hitman Industries. He is Hunter Chambless. How are you, man?
How's it going, everybody? For some reason, they decided to put Hitman Industries members together. I do not like that. Alec, you are a friend of mine, but tonight, you're in my sight, and it's time for you to go bye-bye.
All right. Some tough words there. So you are looking across the desk at, as you said, as at one of your clients, if you will. How are you approaching this match as opposed to any other match?
I'm approaching it just as I would any other match, because at the end of the day, it's my knowledge versus his knowledge. I know what he knows. He doesn't know what I know.
Simple nice. As that. That was a factor we talked about in the broadcast yesterday. So we will definitely see if that plays into this match. Thank you very much, Hunter. We'll drop you out for just a moment, and we will introduce our higher ranked opponent. He is the 13th ranked player in the tournament. He is the sinister one, Alec Miller. How you doing, man?
Doing pretty good, man. I'm looking forward to this. I'm just ready to get this going. I love Hunter, but it's nothing personal, man. I gotta take you out, and let's get it done.
Fair enough. Anything for him, man?
It seems like the two of you are both coming into this with an edge of brotherly love. What do you think it's going to be like afterwards? If one of you obviously will have to beat the other, is that brotherly love still going to be there?
Oh, yeah, man. I mean, us over here in Hitman Industries, we support each other through everything. He's the biggest reason why in combat wrestling trivia, why I've been on the win streak that I am on. So I owe him a lot in there. But if he wins, I'll be right behind him helping him study. And if I win, I know he'll be right there behind me too. So it's going to be all love.
That was awesome. Very sweet. Let's make them fight, Kevin.
Thank you. I was about to say. Now let's put them against each other and see if that really holds up. All right. So, Aaron, if you want to go over the rules for round one, that'd be awesome.
Absolutely. In round number one, it is general geek trivia knowledge. These gentlemen will receive 10 questions in 10 different categories. They will write their answers on their whiteboard within a time limit of roughly 15 seconds. If you get the answer correct, it is worth 1 point. If you get it incorrect, it does not hurt you. You just don't get the point. Each of you will also have 3 repeats and a challenge, which will last you throughout the whole game. If you need the repeat, just make sure you call it out before your 15 seconds is up. If either one of you manages to get all 10 questions correct, you will get the chance to receive a bonus question, which will be worth an extra point. If not, then we don't need to worry about it. Any questions, guys?
Nope. Let's do it.
Oh, we'll do it.
All right.
And you can take question number one away.
Absolutely, guys. And we're going to go ahead and start you in the deep space of Star Trek. And your question is, on what planet does most of Star Trek Insurrection take place? Certainly a deep, deep Geek Cup question to get us started in our tournament. Long tournament.
I was going
to
say, you got to set the right pace. Kind of showing people what to expect. We'll need answer in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down, boards up.
All right, we'll go ahead and start with Hunter for this one.
Vulcan.
And Alec.
I said Kronos.
Fortunately, both of those are incorrect. The answer was Baku.
I would have never got that.
Of course it was.
Don't worry, me neither.
All right, moving on to your second category for the night, Middle Earth. How many rings were given to the race of elves?
This one clearly looking much more to the competitor's speed a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. But there is that always that where you start mixing up the who got what. It's like Christmas. 5, 4.
Goddamn Tolkien with his numbers.
2, 1. Pens down, boards up. And this time we'll start with Hunter. Alec, I'm sorry.
3.
And Hunter.
I said 7.
3 is correct for the elves. So Alec gets a point there.
First blood is drawn. No perfect rounds, unfortunately, but a strong start nonetheless to get the ground running. We'll go ahead and move on to question number 3 for you guys, which will fall in the category of DCEU. Your question is, to where is General Zod sent by the Kryptonian High Council for a somatic reconditioning for his attempted coup? Shout out to the question writer for learning another language to write that goddamn question. Wow. that's the equivalent of let me punch the words in and make them fancier.
True. Makes me sound smart. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down, boards up.
Let's see if they could fight through that maze of words. Hunter.
The Phantom Zone.
And Alec.
The Phantom Zone.
And with that, both gentlemen are correct, and Hunter is on the board, just 1 point behind Alec.
I lost my wifey for my board.
Thank goodness my 50-cent words didn't trip anybody up. We'll move on to weapons, vehicles, technology, and magical objects. In the wizarding world, what sort of potion can change a person's looks to be that of someone else, such as when Barty Crouch Jr. portrays Professor Moody?
Both competitors starting to find their groove and being able to answer these questions. It's a good thing for them.
Thank God it was in the realm of the wizarding world.
Yep. This can be a tricky category for sure. Need answer in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down, boards up. Start with Alec.
The Polyjuice Potion.
And Hunter.
Polyjuice Person.
All right. They are definitely finding their groove now. Polyjuice Potion is correct.
Absolutely. And we're going to go ahead and move on to the halfway point of this round, guys. Question number 5. Come to you in the category of Marvel films. In Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, who voices Jefferson Davis? Just what a great movie. I don't have anything else to add.
Just, I was going to say, it's just a marvel to watch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fence down. We'll go ahead and start with Hunter.
Donald Glover.
And Alec.
I put Mahershala Ali.
Both decent guesses. Unfortunately, we were looking for Brian Tyree Henry.
Ah, damn it.
Funny enough, no. Both of you were thinking Aaron Davis, one in Homecoming and one in Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah.
I figured.
Yep. You guys are all over it, but just shy. All right, moving on to category number 6, which is Star Wars, nothing but Star Wars. What is the name of the monster that lives in a pit below Jabba's palace on Tatooine, which Luke has an interesting run-in with during Return of the Jedi?
I feel like run-in is an interesting choice of words for what entailed.
Right.
Yeah. Hey, it was a very nice conversation they had.
It was pleasantries, you know?
5, 4,
nothing personal.
3, 2, 1, pins down, boards up, and we'll go with Alec.
The Rancor.
Hunter.
I said the Starlight.
Rancor is correct. So Alec takes a 4-2 lead.
That was disrespectful.
I know. Alec takes is hard to say. So noted.
Well, with that, we're going to go ahead and move on to another category that ends with the letter C, DC films. Your question is, what DC villain liked to ask his victim, have you ever danced with the devil in the pale moonlight?
Going back to that Rancor question, I always feel the worst for the guy who's his... like keeper, his guard.
That just gets
he's actually crying after Luke takes care of him. Yeah, it's sad. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pins down. Who said George Lucas was a bad writer?
I'm not even gonna touch that one. Hunter.
Joker.
And Alec.
El Joker.
That is going to be correct. As we move closer and closer, Alec has a score of 5, Hunter not far behind with 3.
Absolutely. Question number 8 comes in the category of the Wizarding World. What does Harry conceal his sock in and give to Lucius Malfoy, which he then gives to Dobby and unintentionally frees him? I do need the specific
for all you Harry Potter fans out there watching. We gave you 2 Wizarding World questions. You're welcome.
Yeah, exactly. I do need the specific object.
Okay.
That's Kevin pandering.
Pretty much. although not, I am not as bad as Maddie. We'll just leave it at that.
Actually, repeat the question.
All right, I can do that for you. Hunter used an early repeat. We'll see if it pays off. In the Wizarding World, what does Harry conceal his sock in and give to Lucius Malfoy, which he then gives to Dobby and unintentionally frees him?
Hunter going for the early repeat to seemingly change an answer that came to his head. Early repeat, unlike a lot of people believe, is not a bad thing as long as it pays off for you in the end.
I couldn't agree more with that sentiment. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pins down, boards up, and we'll start with Alec.
Tom Riddle's Diary.
And Hunter.
Tom Riddle's Diary.
Tom Riddle's Diary is exactly what we were looking for. Great job. And obviously that repeat did pay off.
At first, I wrote a book and I was like, that's not going to be acceptable.
Yep. Good job. Good call there.
All right. And with that, I have the honor of asking you your 9th and penultimate question because Kevin likes reading the longer ones at the end. And it's going to fall into the category of the MCU. And your question is, who portrays Loki in a play put on in Asgard by the false Odin and making a cameo appearance in Thor Ragnarok?
Aaron, do you hate this movie now after our team match?
Actually, ironically enough, shortly after I rewatched it, I still don't love it as much as everyone else, but I actually like it slightly more.
Okay.
I hate myself for how quickly that clicked, but...
Texas, 5, 4.
The first Thor to any of them, but Ragnarok's a close second.
Fair enough. Hunter, you'll reveal first. Go ahead.
Matt Damon.
And Alec.
Matt Damon.
This one of us got a Ragnarok question right. 5-7 is going to be the score heading into the final question. I will let Kevin take away.
And our final question comes, as usual, in plot summary. I'll give you the plot summary of a geek film, and you give me the film. Of course, these are a little bit longer questions, so I'll give you a little bit longer to think about it and answer.
I'll have to answer real quick.
All right, everybody.
It's okay. You couldn't possibly look up a question you haven't been asked yet.
Yeah, sure. Everybody ready?
And if you did, that'd be amazing.
Is there anyway not that?
All right. So here we go with your plot summary question number 10 for the round. Years ago, a stuntman sold his soul to save a loved one. Now he transforms into an avenging agent of justice at night, wherever evil may roam. He is ultimately charged to destroy a demon which plans to bring hell to earth.
Weren't even done with the first sentence they were both writing.
Really?
I like it when that happens. Because it definitely makes it easier on me. Nobody's going to call a repeat thingens. All right. I say that. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pins down, and we'll go to Alec.
Ghost Rider.
And Hunter.
The awful Ghost Rider.
Not a very good film, but very good pull by you guys. It is a bit of a guilty pleasure. There you go. All right, so moving into round number 2, Alec, 8 big points. Hunter, right on his heels with 6. It is definitely anybody's game. Aaron, if you want to give him the rules for round number 2, and I'll get this wheel pulled up.
Absolutely. In round number 2, the competitors will be spinning a wheel. Whatever category comes up, they first spin, they will have the choice of either accepting or spinning again, unless they get opponent's choice. The second spin, if they choose to use it, will be the category they were stuck with. In those categories, there are 5 questions. Each one is worth 2 points apiece, unless you need multiple choice, in which case they will be worth 1 point apiece. In round 2, opponents can steal, so should one of you miss a question, the other will be allowed to steal. And I believe, beginning with this tournament, we are no longer sharing strengths choices, so that is no longer a tactical advantage either of you have when it comes to picking, which should make it more interesting. You guys also still have your repeats and challenges. Hunter, you have 2 of your 3 left. Alec, you have all 3, as do your challenges stand. Anybody have any questions?
Nope.
Nope.
All right. And Aaron is correct. We are no longer at the request of several competitors, no longer going to reveal. Reveal strength. unless you'd like to in the chat, that's totally up to you, but I am not going to be the one to reveal your strength. So for tonight on the wheel, Alec, I'll give you this wheel and you can decide if you'd like to go first or defer to Hunter. So tonight we have on the wheel Star Wars, Harry Potter, no Fantastic Beasts films, MCU, Mixed Bag, Middle Earth, Star Trek, DC, quotes, and of course spinners and opponent's choice.
All right. I'm going to go ahead and let my friend go first because I want to finish my beer.
Thank you, buddy.
That's sweet of you to do. And so here we go. As you can see, it's already been primed. So Hunter, your first spin is in.
Round and round the Green Ranger wheel goes.
And it right on the line, DC.
DC. Ooh, the wheel favors you on this one, Hunter.
Ooh, that was there close. You,
wheel. See, the problem with this is that there's way too many movies in the DC universe. So let's spin that shit again.
All right. Taking a chance, spin it again.
You called it shit, though. Will it bite back because of that?
Yeah, right. That is true.
I hope so.
Is this a Terminator film?
Star Wars. All right. So we will see.
It's fine.
Leave me alone, dog.
We will give Hunter five questions in the realm of Star Wars. And
Sue Breath. I'm gonna let my dog out real quick. I don't know if Sue Breath's actually.
Oh, you're good. You want to take a time out? Yeah, you're fine. You're fine. Yeah. That would be me, but that's okay. As long as I know.
Just let the tension in Hunter's room build a bit more.
Yeah, exactly.
Sorry, I just had to let that dog out, because he would have. He's obnoxious. He would have started like right in front of my face. All right, let's do it.
Let me count back in. 5, 4, 3. All right, so I will have five questions for you, Hunter, in round two in the realm of Star Wars. You do have multiple choice, so feel free to check down to that. Do know that your point total will go from 2 to 1. Alec, be ready for your steals. Both, please keep your hands on screen, and we will get started here. Hunter, are you ready?
Let's go.
All right. Question number one in Star Wars. Finish this Qui-Gon Jinn quote from The Phantom Menace. Those Federation types are blank.
Multiple choice.
All right. I can do that. Your multiple choice options are A, assertive, B, bullies, C, cowards, or D, dramatic.
Can you repeat the choices again, please?
Sure, I can give you a free repeat of the choices. Is it A, assertive, B, bullies, C, cowards, or D, dramatic?
I'm going to go with B as in boy for bully.
All right. B, bullies is incorrect. So I'm going to go over to Alec for a 1 point steal. I'll read you the question and your options. Finish this Qui-Gon Jinn quote from The Phantom Menace. These Federation types are blank. Are they A, assertive, B, bullies, C, cowards, or D, dramatic?
I'm going to go with D, dramatic.
That is also incorrect. So nothing gained, nothing lost. We're looking for cowards. Federation types are cowards.
That was what I was thinking of.
Yeah. All right. So like I said, nothing lost there for Hunter in terms of steals. So he will just try to capitalize on the rest of these questions. Question number two, Hunter, in Star Wars. In The Empire Strikes Back, what does C-3PO say the odds of successfully navigating an asteroid field are, despite Han's confidence to never want to know the odds?
Multiple choice.
All right, multiple choice. Is it A, 3,270 to 1, B, 3,720 to 1, C, 760 to 1, or D, 2,370 to 1.
So many numbers. I'm going to say A.
3,270 to 1 is incorrect. Going to go to Alec for another 1 point opportunity. In Empire Strikes Back, what does C-3PO say the odds of successfully navigating an asteroid field are, despite Han's confidence to never want to know the odds? Is it A, 3,270 to 1, B, 3,720 to 1, C, 760 to 1, or D, 2,370 to 1? That is a lot of numbers. Give Alec a second to think here.
I'm going to say D.
He says D, 2,370 to 1. We were actually looking for 3,720 to 1. That was B. So there you go. Again, a steal opportunity not capitalized on, but three more questions coming at you, Hunter. And your third question in Star Wars. In Attack of the Clones, when Padme suggests she retreats to the Lake Country, for what specific purpose does she state that she used to go there as a child?
Multiple choice.
All right. Is it A, swimming and leisure? B, to be with Paolo? C, to see her grandparents? Or D, for a school retreat? And there went my co-host, but hopefully he'll jump back in.
Sorry, you broke up on one of the multiple choice options for me.
I'll give those to you one more time. All right, is it A, swimming and leisure? B, to be with Paolo? C, to see her grandparents? Or D, for a school retreat?
It's one of the two. I'm going to go with A.
A, swimming and leisure. That is incorrect. Going to go to Alec for an opportunity again. In Attack of the Clones, when Padme suggests she retreats to the Lake Country, for what specific purpose does she state that she used to go there as a child? Is it A, swimming and leisure? B, to be with Paolo? C, to see her grandparents? Or D, for a school retreat? Welcome back, Aaron.
What is the updated score so I can update it? I apologize.
We are still at the same score.
Okay,
yep. Cool. I'm going to say B.
B was to be with Paolo. I think she probably did see Paolo, but the reason she gave was for a school retreat. For a school retreat. All right. So neither one really capitalizing here on the Star Wars, the Star Wars slice. But we still do have two questions to go. So let's see how that works out. Your penultimate question, Hunter, in Star Wars, in A New Hope, how many engines can be seen on the rear of the shuttle Tana V4?
Phone's going off. My bad, guys. Shane's over there now.
Multiple choice.
Is it A, 7, B, 3, C, 9, or D, 11? A7. That is incorrect. So I'm going to go back over to Alec. In A New Hope, how many engines can be seen on the rear of the shuttle Tana V4? Is it A7, B3, C9, or D11?
Is it B3?
B3, that is incorrect. We're looking for 11. 11.
Of course it is. You and your numbers, Kevin. God.
Now, as we move into the final question here, the good thing for Hunter is that Alex has struggled about as much as he has. So there has been no capitalization here. Hunter be able to pull a two-pointer on this question, the game will be tied.
Exactly. Thank you very much for that, Aaron. So, that's a great pointing that out. So, so that, you know, Hunter's not, he's not out of it by any means. All right. So your fifth and final question in round two, Hunter, for Star Wars. What is Obi-Wan's call sign in the battle over Coruscant seen in the opening shots of The Revenge of the Sith?
Multiple choice.
All right. Is it A, red leader, B, gold leader, C, blue leader, or D, blue two?
A.
A, red leader is correct for 1 point. So it does.
It was A.
does salvage one out of that.
I do like Star Wars, guys. I just wanted to point that out.
I will say for all intents and purposes, the fact that we've had a huge Star Wars tournament, we have run through a lot of Star Wars questions. So
yeah.
If anybody is saying, man, those were really deep, or man, those weren't round two questions. They were, all right. And again,
Star Wars League.
yeah, this
is all good.
Yep. But this is also the tournament, so they'll only get harder from here. But Alec is up now with his spin, and we will go ahead and give him his first spin now.
Go.
The wheel goes round. Let's see what this bitch will do next.
And as usual in every match, Star Trek.
Spinning again.
And as usual, a competitor spins away from poor old Star Trek.
Someone gets
more love.
It's definitely been used.
True. We have Spinner's Choice.
Good job.
So, you want to hear your options again, Alec?
No, I know what I want. Let's go Middle Earth.
All right, he's going to go Middle Earth. And I didn't mean to put that juju on you, Aaron, but I think most of these names are pretty simple. I'll let you take those away.
Oh, it's fine. It's fine. I've actually seen these now. I have a shot here. Let's do this.
There you go.
Right. So I haven't seen The Hobbit, so I didn't care as much. But, all right, here we go.
Do you want to fix the screen real quick before?
Yeah, sure.
Yes,
I can do that. Yeah, why not?
There we go. All right.
I guess if you guys like FaceTime, but. All right. So here's how it goes. Obviously, because of Hunter's round, the score is still 8-7, which means a great round for Alec could put him in a really good position. However, the score is so close that if Hunter can even nab one or two steals, this will very much still be a manageable game. Let's see where it goes. All right, Alec, your first question in the category of Middle Earth. What is the name of the meeting held by the Ents in the Two Towers?
It's called the Ent Moot.
That is going to be correct for 2 points. All right, and for question number two, what is another name for Mirkwood Forest in Middle Earth?
Need an answer or multiple choice in 5.
I'm going to go multiple choice.
Okay. Absolutely. Your options are A, Fangorn, B, Black Forest, C, Greenwood, or D, Lotharine.
Lothlorien.
Lothlorien. Sure, I tried.
Let me go D, Lothlorien.
All right, and that is going to be incorrect, which means Hunter will get a chance to steal the point back. Hunter, your question of multiple choice options are, what is another name for Mirkwood Forest in Middle Earth? Is it A, Fangorn, B, Black Forest, C, Greenwood, or D, Lothlorien?
I'm going to say A.
That is also going to be incorrect. The answer we were looking for is C, Greenwood.
That sounded way too simple to be the answer. So.
Sometimes the simple answer is the answer. All right, Alec, we'll go ahead and move on to... to point out, going into this round, there was an opportunity for a knockout. With that miss, we will be going to round 3 no matter what.
Let's go!
That's correct.
Barely surviving!
Alec, your question in Middle Earth. Who plays Dwalin in the Hobbit series?
Multiple choice.
All right, your options are A, Graham McTavish, B, Aidan Turner, C, James Nesbitt, or D, Ken Stott.
I'm Is it A?
That is correct for a point, as he increases his lead ever so slightly with that one. We're going to go ahead and move on to your penultimate question in Middle Earth. Chilob's lair is located off of what path?
Oh, why am I blanking on the fucking name? Let me get the multiple choice.
I hate you. All right.
Sorry.
You want me to give it to me?
No, I can do this one. All right.
Okay.
Options are Sirith Ungol, B, minus Tirith, C, Sirith Fangorn, or D, minus Morgul.
It's Kirith Ungol.
Even with my fuck up, he got it. That is going to be correct. I tried. I'm trying, man.
Hey, I knew he knew what you were doing. Somebody would.
I'm trying. All right. In your final question here, question number 5 in the category of Middle Earth. Frodo gets Sting from Bilbo. Where did Bilbo get Sting from?
I wonder how specific I need to be. Let me get the multiple choice just to be safe. Damn it.
All right. A, Elrond. B, a cave. C, Galadriel. Or D, the Mines of Moria.
B, a cave?
That is correct. Yes, for a point.
Yeah.
Where the troll horde is. Yep.
Yeah, I was like, how specific do they need to be? And then when I heard the cave, I was like, oh, not at all.
It did say troll in the answer option in case you wanted to go for that too, but cave was what we would have accepted.
Okay.
All right. So that wraps up round number 2. Alec, that last point was actually a real big point. That puts him up by 6 points. Which will mean that Hunter will have to hit his 5 to send it back over. But it's still anybody's game. Like I said before, Geek is one of those where even those last numbers that you pick can be a biatch. All right. So, Aaron, if you want to go over the rules of round number 3.
Absolutely. Round number 3 is essentially a game of chance, gentlemen. We have 12 categories, each assigned to a number, 1 through 12. You're going to pick 3 numbers. The order you pick them in will be giving them a point's worth. Your first number will be worth 2 points, your second 3, and your last one 5. You will answer the questions accordingly in order to take back the lead. There will be no opportunities for stealing, and you do still have your repeats and your challenges. Hunter, you go into this round with 2 left. Alec, you have all 3. Do you have any questions? Yep.
Yes, nope. Sir. No, that's it.
And so with that, Alec, because you are in the lead, you will pick your numbers first. Give me 3 numbers between 1 and 12.
All right. I'm going to go over my son's birthday as I normally do. I'm going to go 4, 2, and 3.
Recurring theme on the admin team to blame your kids if you mess up. Hunter, you're going to go ahead and pick your numbers except for 2, 3, and 4.
Thank you for not picking these. I'm going 6, 1, and 9 because Rey Mysterio.
Oola, ooh, booyah, booyah.
Short, sweet, and simple.
Six, yes, one, my son will carry the burden of my failures if I
Right.
And I will be training him to avenge my loss if this okay, happens. he's only 2, but we'll figure it out.
I mean, I'm probably right. Him in the next team's match.
All right.
So going into round number 3, I have Alec picking numbers 4, 2, and 3. Hunter is picking numbers 6, 1, and 9. Since I gave Hunter his round 2 questions, we will switch. Aaron, if you will give Hunter his round 3 questions. And I will do Alec's.
Let's do this!
Absolutely. And Hunter, your first number in round 3 was number 6, which is going to be assigned to the category of mixed bag.
Okay.
And your 2-pointer is, what mixed bag film stars James McAvoy, Angelina Jolie, Chris Pratt, and Common?
Wanted.
And that is going to be correct for 2 points to bring the score up 13-9. And we're going to go ahead and keep this show on the road, as your second number was category number one, which means your three-pointer is going to fall under the category of Star Wars.
Fuck!
Here we go. Your three-pointer. In Return of the Jedi, what is the name of the shuttle used by Han, Leia, Luke, and Chewie to get past the second Death Star and to the forest moon of Endor?
Blow that fucker up. I don't know.
I'm sure the Empire were saying that, but that is not the correct answer. The answer we were looking for was Shuttle Tidarium, or simply Tidarium.
Nope.
All right, and that means we are going to go ahead and move on to your five-pointer, Hunter. For Mr. Mysterio himself, you picked number 9, which is going to put you in the category of movie quotes.
Okay.
All right, and your five-pointer is, and remember, you do still have two repeats remaining.
All right.
Your five-pointer is, what MCU character says, this is a new day, this is a new beginning?
Need an answer or repeat in 5, 4, 3? Okay.
Absolutely. That'll be your second one. For 5 points in the category of movie quotes, which MCU character says, this is a new day, this is a new beginning?
Will you accept hero name as well, or does it have to be first and last name?
The answer is a first and last name.
Okay.
And we'll need a repeat or answer in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right.
All right. Your last repeat, Hunter, for 5 points in the category of movie quotes. What MCU character says, this is a new day, this is a new beginning?
Alec? Congratulations. I'm going to go with Sam Wilson.
And your winner by technical knockout, advancing on to face Robert Kastner in round 2, Sinister, Alec Miller.
Hunter, the answer we were looking for was Dr. Eric Selvig.
Fuck that. I don't know.
A very tough question. We will go ahead and talk to Alec. Hunter will be right back with you. Thank you, sir. All right. So, man, how are you feeling about this one?
I'm good, man. I needed this win so bad, man. I've been on like a losing streak in leagues, man. I needed this. My goal in every match is to get it, especially if it's the typical third round of you got to hit the 2, the 3, and the 5. My goal is to always be above 6 points, up by 6 points, to cause them to make them have to hit that 5-pointer, because that 5-pointer is a toughie. And if I can make it where they have to hit that one, then I don't got to hit any. I don't have to hit any of the third round.
Yeah, that's an excellent strategy. And you know, like you said, I mean, those fives are, you know, as deep as deep gets. But yeah, you took care of business in round 1. You got your spinner's choice. You went with your strength of Middle Earth there in round 2. So, you know, you did have to go to multiple choice, but you navigated it well. So yeah, you did exactly what needed to be done technically and all to win this game. So, congratulations. We can bring up the
Yep, so going little, into the next round, your match, Alec, will be against Mr. Robert Kastner, who was one of the last matches we had in regular season before going into the tournament, in which I believe he TKO'd my future opponent, Nico Rigoli. It was a solid performance on his part. So what do you know about Robert? How are you feeling going into it? How are you feeling going forward down the road?
Well, I don't know much about Robert, but I mean, if he's TKOing guys, you know, it is Nico, and I love Nico, but it is Nico. I'm definitely going to make sure that if, like, you know, with my strength, I shouldn't have gone multiple choice as many times as I did. And they were all ones that as soon as I heard the answer, I knew what it was, except that one that I missed, obviously. But, you know, make sure that I have my strengths up to day, you know, in my head, because I don't know if he's going to give me his strengths. If he does, great. If he doesn't, you know, it is what it is. So I just got to make sure that I know what I know and not mess up on it and, you know, shore up some of my shortcomings, especially in Star Wars. I'll probably end up watching that tonight.
Yeah, I was going to ask, you know, did that get you down at all, you know, watching Hunter go first and then kind of missing out on what could have been several SEAL opportunities, or did you just kind of let that slide off and think, okay, I still got my round to go?
I kind of let that slide off, you know, because I knew I still had my round. And all the other categories besides Star Trek, I felt really confident in. So I wasn't too worried, but I am. And a lot of those questions, they're super deep cuts. Like that, the fact that we had just had a Star Wars tournament, like you said, like it kind of made you have to go deep on these questions. And I mean, they were all, you know, they could have been. I wasn't thinking the answer most of the time anyways. I was just going with what I thought. So, sure. No, it didn't like affect me in any way. It's probably more of the Middle Earth ones that I'm kind of like kicking myself for. I'm probably gonna end up going back and watching those too. So that's probably more what I'm gonna focus on, you know, not even going multiple choice and going with my gut more often, because I knew that Kated Ungol one. I just wanted and the cave one too with Sting. I knew that one. I just you know, second guessed myself.
I hear you.
Well, as long as you have the wiggle room, it never hurts to second guess, but certainly confidence proves worthy the deeper you go. But it was still a solid performance. 8 points in round one is consistent with your first match, and you showed in your first match, obviously, despite it ending up being a loss, you can hang in round three, so should we have to go there in the future, you should certainly feel confident in that at least.
Yeah, damn you, Eisenhower.
I was gonna say you do have that as an upper hand on Robert because he hasn't seen any round three questions yet, so that is one thing to take in as far as in TM Geek, but yeah, I would say you do have a tough opponent ahead of you. Good luck in your next matchup, and Absolutely. Yep, and we will see you we'll see you soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner for today, Alec Miller, now with a 1-1 and 1 TKO record.
I like it.
All right. And let's bring in our unfortunate second place finisher. There are no losers around here. Hunter Chambless. So Star Wars, that was just a brutal category. I mean, you can see even when your opponent's missing them, that it's just a tough category. Do you feel like that kind of deflated any momentum you might have had coming out of round one?
Not really, because my downfall was really not going with DC. I know DC movies, and I was just thinking of the fact that there are decades upon decades of DC movies out there, that it could literally be any movie. But the problem with Star Wars is that there are so few movies. You have to go really deep, guys, especially after having a tournament like that.
Right.
But, you know, if I had to lose, I'm glad I lost someone like Alec, a buddy of mine. And definitely everyone in this tournament be ready and be worried, because me and Alec are going to train our asses off and get him that fucking belt.
Absolutely. All right. That's one thing I wanted to ask. Are you going to take on the manager role from here on out for Alec and be in his corner?
Yes, of course. If I'm able to be on screen, that'd be great. Being there for Alec, we'll definitely be studying. I got to study myself because I definitely want to come back and prove myself. I have a teenies match coming up, so hopefully I can do better in there. But overall, I mean, I didn't do that well today, but my role right now is getting Alec to that belt.
Gotcha.
Aaron, absolutely. Yeah, I was going to say, certainly round two was the downfall. It just... such deep cut questions. The first thought I had for you was, What was going through your head more in round two? Was it the fact of like the you keep missing the questions and missing out on the points, or was there more even a little bit of a sense of relief that he was also missing them, which meant even though you couldn't gain, it became inconsequential that you continued to miss it?
It's a little bit of both, because, you know, obviously you don't want to get steals. You don't want your opponent to be able to steal points off of you. The only thing that was really like frustrating me is the fact that when I would go with multiple choice, I would have to think in my head which one sounds like the correct answer. And you fight with your mind and you fight with your psyche a little bit, because you think it's one answer when it turns out to be another. I'm just glad that I didn't get give him the opportunity to steal any points. So we did go into round number three. I think I got a steal off of him. So Middle Earth, I mean, I knew a few of those. But overall, I mean, you know, I definitely know I can do better if I actually put my mind to it. But right now, as I said, I'm focusing on getting Alec what he wants, which is that belt here in Team Geek.
Nice. Absolutely. And then the final question I had was, obviously, with the loss today, unfortunately, you were at an 0-2 record in the Geeks specifically, and you were out for the rest of the tournament. But upon return to regulation play, when we have our champion, we'll be starting to look to go back into our members of TM Geek and start making matchups. And anyone who loses in this first round will be at an 0-2 record, which will make them eligible to take you on. Is there anyone you can think of in the first round that you think could be an interesting matchup should the cards fall that way?
Can I see the tournament bracket again, please?
Why not throw it up there? Sure.
There you go.
Oh, thank you.
My bad. I clicked it.
Yeah, me too. Sorry about that. For those of you at home that can see that.
Andrea, I'm looking for the loser between Andrea and Jacob West. Always good if Nico loses to go up against Nico. And Amaru. I think Amaru would be fun.
Definitely. It's some potential matchups there for sure once the tournament ends. So we have some definite awesome matchups to look forward to. Thank you so much, Hunter. We look forward to having you as a manager, and we'll have you on the desk, I'm sure. For some matches.
Number one faction in all of the fucking leagues, ladies and gentlemen.
You heard it here first from the Hitman himself, Hunter Chambliss. Thanks, man. We'll see you next time. All right. So that wraps up our first match, and it was a bit of a defensive struggle there in round number two, it looked like, but Alec showing some prowess and taking home the TKO. How do you think that's going to fare into the next round?
I think it certainly gives him a confident boost. You know, Robert is being in the upper echelon of the few people in this league that have had a TKO or KO win is certainly a confidence booster for him. And so Alec, you know, we've talked about it before, the triple threat that we participated in alongside Alan. Alec losing on 16 points, I believe it was, or 17 points. That's a winning score in most matches. And now to come in today and be able to have a TKO on his record as well is certainly just everything more of a confident boost going forward. And also, I think one of the things that can lay into people is when you have a bit of a high tension match, knowing that despite the fact that he won today, his opponent is immediately going to turn around and put everything he has into wanting to help him is not something you see often. So I think it's certainly a comforting factor here. And I think things turned out the best they could have for Alec. Certainly exciting to see him going forward.
Yeah, absolutely. I couldn't agree more. I'm interested to see how that dynamic plays out with him bringing a manager next time, having somebody to study with, and taking on a really good opponent in Robert Kastner. So from all of us here at TMG Trivia, TM Geek, my co-host Aaron, our competitors for the evening, Sinister Alec Miller, our winner advancing in the tournament, our second place finisher, Hunter Chambliss, his Alec's new, or not new, but new in TM Geek manager. So be on the lookout for Hitman Industries. They are here, and they are here to get some belts. But thank you for tuning in. Tune into all of our tournament matches, and make sure to keep geeking out, guys. See you next time.